Now that we know what a z-score is, let's figure out what we can do with one. There are three common uses for z-scores. The first is that z-scores are used for comparing scores from different distributions. If you live in the Midwest in the United States, you probably took the ACT before you were admitted to college. ACT scores range from 1 to 35, with a mean of 21, and a standard deviation of 5. If you live on either of the coasts in the United States, you probably took the SAT. The SAT has a mean of 500 and a standard deviation of 100, with scores ranging between 200 and 800. So how can we compare them? If I got a 650 on the SAT, but you got a 32 on the ACT, should I be bragging about how much better I did? I mean, 650 is much larger than 32. But by converting to z-scores, the answer is clear. My z-score of a positive 1.50 is lower than your z-score of a positive 2.20. Now we can easily see that you did much better. The second use for z-scores is for computing the relative frequencies of scores from any distribution. How many people scored 32 or less on the ACT? Using a z-table, I can determine that 98.6% of other test takers scored below your score. Third, z-scores are used for hypothesis testing and interpreting sample means with a z-test. What is the probability that you would score a 32 on the ACT just by random guessing? A z-score can tell us that the probability is 0.0139. If you took the ACT 100 times using random guessing, only once could you be expected to perform this well by chance. Knowing that, I think that it is unlikely that you guessed your way to a score of 32. Instead, you really know your stuff. A z-score distribution is the distribution that results after transforming any distribution of raw scores into z-scores. Do you recognize this pan? It's called a bundt pan. Now, the cool thing about a bundt pan is that no matter what kind of cake mix you pour into it, German chocolate, yellow, white, red velvet, it always comes out looking like a bundt cake. No matter what distribution you pour into the z-score formula, it always comes out in a z-score distribution. A standardized z-score distribution is always in the shape of a normal curve. This is the distribution that we will use for calculations. It's important to know that converting a distribution to z-scores does not transform the shape of the original distribution. So if you calculate z-scores with a highly skewed distribution of scores, the distribution will still be skewed, but the numbers will be comparable with other z-distributions. And this is because a z-score distribution always has a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. Even if the original distribution is non-normal, the z-scores will still have a mean of 0 and standard deviation of 1. This is what makes z-scores comparable from different distributions. It also means that the z-score of positive 1.45 is also 1.45 standard deviations above the mean. Z-scores exceeding positive or negative 1.96 are statistically significant. The number of scores between a z of positive and negative 1.96 is exactly 95% of the scores. The farther that a z-score is above the mean, the larger the value of the raw score. And of course, the further a z-score is below the mean, the smaller the value of that raw score. And finally, in a normal distribution, the z-scores are seldom greater than plus or minus 3 standard deviations. This is because of the nature of a normal distribution. Roughly speaking, you will find approximately 2/3 of the scores in a distribution between one standard deviation above and one standard deviation below the mean. About 95% of the scores are between two standard deviations above and two standard deviations below the mean. And approximately 99% of the scores are between three standard deviations above and three standard deviations below. Because 99% of the scores are less than positive or negative 3, it is highly unlikely that you will find scores beyond that Z value. So here is the Z score formula in symbols. Z equals X minus mu divided by sigma, where Z is your Z score, X is the raw score, mu is the population mean, and sigma is the population standard deviation. The Z score is describing how far a raw score falls from the mean in standard deviation units. Remember this formula because we will use it next.